So this year at ACE in Los Angeles, in the annual meeting of the American College of Clinical Endocrinology, there were a lot of diabetes focused sessions. ACE has been at the forefront of the guidelines much before the ADA-ESD guidelines and the consensus statement came out. ACE was the first to come out with an algorithm where a hierarchical preference to medications was given. After metformin, what next? They were able to give a hierarchical preference to an SGLT2 inhibitor. They have been a very inclusive guideline. For example, ACE is the only guideline which has alpha-glucosidase inhibitors in it. ACE is the only guideline which still recognizes secretagogue and glitazones and does not put a preferential treatment, but it is clearly delineating it as per the evidence base which is existing. So this year at ACE, there were a lot of diabetes focus sessions. There was, of course, the updated version of the ACE diabetes guidelines. They have the contemporary ACE lipid guidelines and the ABCD approach, where they are looking at chronic disease management categories. So all those diagnostic pathways have been well mapped at the American College of Endocrinology meeting. One of the main keynote addresses at the ACE meeting this year was by Professor Roy Taylor. Roy Taylor and his group from UK have been at the forefront of reversal of diabetes, and they have really shown that diabetes remission is doable. What Professor Taylor told us is that if you are a type 2 diabetic and if you are able to restrict your calories to just 600 or 800 calories with type 2 diabetes with a disease duration less than 6 years, and if you are on oral agents, not on insulin, then it is possible if you get 15 kilograms or more weight loss, then you can remit diabetes in at least 50% or more cases. And you can keep your A1C medicines free for with A1C below 6.5 for at least 2 years. So he has actually showed us the diabetes remission which is possible. Initially he showed this in his original work, which was the point counterpoint study, which was a couple of years back. Then 2 years back he showed it in the direct trial, and now at the ACE he showed us how reversal is possible. In fact, diet and medical nutrition therapy is the only way you can restore the first phase of insulin secretion by severe caloric restriction. The data of Professor Taylor is as good as bariatric surgery. So remember that drastic caloric restriction with meal replacement, with liquid formula diets of 600 calories can actually reverse diabetes. And that's what Professor Taylor gave a plenary at the ACE meeting. The other thing which was highlighted at ACE was diabetes technologies. Because now we know that, and in fact I also had an abstract on structured testing and how structured testing, two latest digital apps, are making a difference in quality of life of diabetics. They are incorporating a behavioral change, and we are getting newer and newer continuous glucose monitoring techniques which are integrated with different apps, with different technologies, with Bluetooth which are enabled, with internet and so on and so forth. And therefore, it is very easily possible to have the patient talk to their healthcare providers with a seamless interface. And that is something which has been happening in a big way. And there was actually a workshop on diabetes technologies, what's new. Beyond diabetes technology and diabetes remission, what was highlighted at ACE is, of course, the current contemporary trials on cardiovascular outcome trials in diabetes. And what was most discussed was the just presented Melbourne trial of the CREDENCE trial, which was basically showing for the first time that SGLT2 inhibitors not only can protect the heart but also can protect the kidneys. So prevention and protection of kidney and heart is doable, and that's something which is very, very likely. We also had a lot of path-breaking abstracts. There were a lot of oral and poster presentations which are all done electronically. There was no physical poster at all, so that was very, so it was a very digital conference, and it was a paperless conference. And that is where the world is moving very fast. The other interesting tenet discussed at ACE was the interesting connect between liver and diabetes. We all know that even if you are not drinking alcohol, you can get fatty liver. And non-alcoholic fatty liver and diabetes is closely linked. And that was all discussed in a very thematic fashion in a big way. The other thing which is at the spotlight in diabetes is diabetes retinopathy, and that also got discussed a lot at the ACE meeting. But I think the core still remains, which gets discussed at ACE, is the ACE algorithm. And they have a very nice way of treating diabetes. For example, at entry, if your A1C is below 7.5, you start with metformin and you can add any of the five agents. You can add a secretagogue, you can add a glitazone, you can add an alpha glucosidase inhibitor, you can add an SGLT2 inhibitor, you can add a gliptin. Any of the five agents you can add based on the affordability, accessibility, weight, hypoglycemia, cardiorenal protection. All these come as criteria to add the second agent. But by and large, good lifestyle modification, behavioral therapy and metformin can manage most of your patients if their A1C is below 7.5%. If your entry level A1C is between 7.5 and 9, then the ACE guidance says that you will normally need at least two agents or three agents to control your diabetes. And that is very critical. So therefore, you can add any of the two or three agents. Usually metformin is a part of that backbone. And that is where a gliptin and SGLT2 inhibitor have crept in a bigger way. But all other agents are very much there. If your entry A1C is above 9% and if you are symptomatic with osmotic symptoms like, you know, polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia or weight loss, then it's insulin straight. However, if you're asymptomatic and your A1C is above 9%, you can attempt triple therapy. So ACE guideline has been one of the first guidelines in the Western world to recognize the importance of dual therapy and triple therapy. In India, we have always been using fixed dose combinations for a long time, but dual and triple therapy always has been viewed with a little circumspect. But ACE is one of the first bodies in the world to recognize that the importance of dual therapy and triple therapy in management of type 2 diabetes. So from that standpoint, it is a very important guideline. Also, what ACE recognizes is the role of medical nutrition therapy, the role of exercise and behavioral change, and the role of monitoring in integrating diabetes care. And ACE guideline is just not about managing a glucose or A1C value. It's not only about A1C, but it's also about blood pressure, it's also about lipids, and it's also about medical nutrition therapy, correct dietary practices and exercise practices. A lot has also been discussed in this ACE meeting on medical weight loss, because we know that we can now get weight loss both through lifestyle and also through very good medicines which are available, including agents like injectable agents like GLP-1 analogs, SGLT2 inhibitors. There are specific weight loss drugs like Orlistat and Locarcerin which are available, and many of the neuromodulators in the brain. So therefore, remember, weight loss is a very doable entity, and medical nutrition therapy is at its core, and diabetic specific nutrition is also important. So from that standpoint, this year's ACE meeting has been very, you know, enriching our knowledge in making lives of people living with diabetes better. And that is something which is very doable. So what probably would be a take home message for everybody from the ACE meeting is that it has a very simple algorithm. At entry, if your A1C is below 7.5, usually lifestyle with metformin will do the job, and you can even reverse this diabetes, which is what Professor Taylor's work is showing. If your A1C is between 7.5 and 9, if you are only on one or two agents, if your duration of diabetes is less than 10 years or 6 years, and if you lose 15 kilograms of weight, again you can reverse diabetes. But usually dual therapy is needed when the A1C is between 7.5 and 9. And when your duration of diabetes is more, or if you are symptomatic, or if your A1C is above 9%, then beyond triple therapy, you might need insulin. And therefore, we should not be afraid to use insulin. Having said all this, we also are integrating now diabetes technology, diabetes apps with the day-to-day management of diabetes today in a very structured way. In the good old days, it was very unstructured. Now we are doing structured testing and ensuring that we are integrating our treatment paradigms, dual triple drug regimens with a structured fashion so that we can maintain a normal A1C. And it's not just A1C which is important. Blood pressure control, lipid control is as important as glucose control, and that's what the ACE guidelines has always taught us. Thank you.